It seemingly appears that whatever the former royal Prince Harry does, seemingly also has something of a public backlash. But what has happened this time? More importantly, why? Hi, good morning. Neil Sean here in the heart of London. Thank you for joining me today. This is a rather serious story, in fact, because it's a rather tragic story too. It all centres on the time that Prince Harry was a serving officer in Afghanistan way back in 2008. Seems so long ago that now, doesn't it, when you think about it? We certainly know, don't we, from Prince Harry's time in the military, that that was seemingly one of the most happiest times of his life. He spoke about being free and being one of the boys, being able to do really what he wanted to do all of his life. But this particular story centres on a rather sad story, really, all about, as I say, a fellow serving officer, Nathan Hunt, who served alongside Prince Harry, as I say, way back in 2008. Prince Harry recently wrote to the parents of Mr. Hunt, who sadly took his own life in 2018, following a long, long battle with mental illness. You know, you do have to have such huge sympathy for all of these very young boys who go out to fight and protect us around the world, and what scars it leaves them when you think about it being so young. They may be prepared for battle, but they're not necessarily prepared for life. But here as ever is where the story gets really interesting, because in this letter that Prince Harry wrote, he said to the parents of Mr. Hunt that he wished he could do more, but given the fact that now he doesn't have the same power since being stripped from his military titles, that he can't, basically. Now this, as I say, has received something of a backlash over here in the United Kingdom, and it's a very difficult situation, you know, very thin line to tread. A lot of people are basically claiming that, well, Prince Harry could do more. He does have a public voice, and that's true. Seemingly, he could jump on social media, do an interview, Zoom chat, whatever, and that could be made public, and simply by his mere presence could raise the questions and, you know, the background to this particular story that needs to be raised and discussed. Others are basically saying, well, he's been a bit petulant because, having been stripped from his titles by Our Gracious Majesty the Queen, well, I can't do anything. As I say, with Prince Harry, it's either one or the other. Seemingly, he can never quite get the middle ground right. A lot of people, as I say, do respect the fact that he did go out and go to war for his country. Whatever people say online, etc., it's still a dangerous area to go to. And for that, we are all truly thankful. But if I was Prince Harry, I would re-look at this particular situation and think, well, what more good could I do? I still have a public voice. And this, more importantly, could be used to far better use than moaning about being cut off from his family, financial problems, and having to sign for Netflix. I'm sure we'll all agree on that particular note. Neil Sean in the very heart of London.